Hello friends, welcome back. Today I'll have a very short video to share with you my visit to a friend's place. He is a seller on a marketplace on Facebook, and I had gone to his place to pick up some plants. This is a lovely collection of anthuriums he had at the front porch, and I was amazed by the variety of anthuriums that he had. If you look closely at the roots, he has grown all of them in coconut shells without any soil medium, and they are doing perfectly fine because they get the morning sunlight. So he says accordingly that the morning sunlight just works best for the anthuriums that he has planted. And let me tell you, he does have a variety of anthuriums which are just amazing to look at. The next thing in line was his private collection of succulents. We'll quickly have a walkthrough through the succulents. The first one was the donkey's tail. He has a couple of Haworthias as well as aloe varieties. Yes, it belongs to his private collection, but sooner or later he would be selling them to his customers. If you look at the variety, he has more of this low maintenance succulent, so no wonder it is at his front porch and there is not much care that is required. This is a rare variety. These are other aloes that he has added, and also he makes these trellises as well as his garden ornaments. Like this one is made by him and it is kept there for sale. I've never seen such wonderful flowers of bromeliads which are being mounted on a coconut tree, and it is giving him good results without any soil, just the roots are being on the coconut tree. Also for sale were his collection of orchids. Now this was mounted on a wooden piece and it is like giving him good flowers. Of course the rates are very high, which I have not asked for because I feel it's not, because I cannot care for orchids so much. He also has his bird nest fern which adores his front area, which is again mounted on a wooden piece. The orchid flowers look lovely, a lovely orange color. Besides this orchid, he also has more collection. I still do not know the varieties of orchids, but then this is what he had in his collection. This is a lovely pink. Besides that, he had another color. Okay, this is a pink. This is a dark pink and a white. And a white here. It looks so pretty. And it's not been cut or kept in the house or in a vase or anything. This is a ground orchid that was also doing very well. This plant gets the full afternoon sunlight, hence I think it's called as ground orchids. Also in his area were this variety of adenium plants which he himself has propagated to a large number of plants which are for sale for rupees 500 and above. Next in his garden was this Hoya carnosa mounted on a net, a steel net, okay, and it also has given flowers, but if you look at it, it's not cared for. In the sense, the moment I would see my Hoya carnosa flowers, I would be treasuring them like gold. But I think when you have too much of Hoyas, you do not care or you do not value them enough. Here, and as you can see, it is a long trail and then a flower, lovely to look at. This is another variety of anthuriums that he had. This is for sale. He charges 400 for per stem, and this variety is rupees 500. So you can imagine there are so many plants in this pots that he can actually make a fortune by selling it. That is all, friends. I captured it because I was so amazed with the variety of anthuriums and other plants that he had. Thank you so much for watching. I see you again in the next one. Please do like, share and subscribe to the channel in case you're new.